what do you think in FAR? Because I know you were a chartered as well. So did you find similar to CA, or this was completely different, US GAAP? And because we have in India, Ind AS, and I think at our time it was accounting standards. Now it is US converged with IFRS. So did you find anything similar to what we have read it in our chartered accountancy final, or this was really different?
This is different. This is, the standards are not really given how it was given to us. These are just chapters and modules, bits and pieces, which probably don't make any sense. You just have to start making sense on your own. It's not as in-depth as CA. So because CA has three levels, gradually you ramp up. This is like one shot, everything there, just do it. It's different from CA in that sense. But its proportion is huge. You can take anywhere between 2 to 3 months to finish the portion, I think. You need to keep doing those questions again and again. The Becker's practice test, those are very important, I think. I used to do them after every chapter. I would keep adding on questions, keep making my own questions or my own tests to keep revising what I had finished, to keep in touch with what is done, because otherwise by the time you come to module 10, you would have forgotten what's happened in module 1. And you're like, what did I do? You spent 2 months and you're like, what just happened? I don't know what just happened. So important to keep doing those questions, keep revising, keep redoing. It's vast, it's not easy. You need to be dedicated, have a planned approach. Call of the question, very, very important. There are a lot of things which are unnecessary, just there to panic you guys. Just keep a cool, calm mind. It's just one more exam. Sit down properly, give it your best shot and come out. That's all.
Prerna, what do you think? I know, again, CA ka audit tha, yeah, this was a little change.
Actually, this was CA ka audit. It wasn't very different. For me, at least, I found it very easy after FAR. Because FAR is vast, I didn't find FAR difficult, but it was vast, so it took a lot of my mental effort. Audit seems like a breeze, very similar to Indian CA. It is, I don't know if it was my work experience also as an auditor, like in articleship and later. But there were a lot of things, like if you think like an auditor, I think it helps you crack that question. And as everybody is saying, there are these few questions where you boil down to those last two things. You know two are definitely wrong. Between those two things. And the answers also say, this is the best choice. This could have been right, but this is the best choice. So you really, the language, the nuances. I think CPA exam in that way is a little different for us because of the nuances. It's small things that they picked up. They're testing your knowledge. This is not like CA where you can just write an essay answer and, you know, they're looking for keywords. It's not that. Here your knowledge is being tested. So you need to understand. That's the key here. So apart from that, I thought it was like a breeze for me. Out of the four, that was the easiest for me.
How was right for you? And what are the top three things one need to master?
What really helps is making notes. Regulation is all about giving it repetition. Notes really, really help in this subject because it's all new to us. It's nothing like Indian taxation. In fact, for me, I was trying not to get into Indian taxation with this because it's completely different. And I was remembering stuff that I remembered 10 years ago. I studied CA final like in 2011. And I'm like, I don't want those sections right now. Don't come in my head. Just completely, for me, what works is not thinking of Indian taxation. This is completely different, completely new. Do not get confused with what you've done before. Repetition is the key. I think what also helps is reading that question twice. For regulation also, I think you need to know what's the call of the question and what he's, the small words, the words are different from Indian. We're not used to a lot of words, so you need to understand what those words mean in taxation. Basis is very important, I think. And I think I screwed up a couple of my questions in basis. Which was very tense about my results. Well, I got an 86, so I'm happy.
Last comes the BEC, which is Business Environment.
Same, it was the toughest for me out of all the four. Individually, all the six modules seemed easy. I didn't have a problem getting through them. But whenever I did those practice exams, the mock exams, I don't know why I would always feel I didn't do well enough. I told the exam, I came out, I'm like, I'm just gonna pass. And I got a 79. I don't know why it's easy for a lot of people, but somehow there is something, it's a little tricky. I haven't been able to put my hand on what was tricky about it. It seems easy when you're doing it, but as a consolidation of all those things and an amalgamation of so many different components, I think somewhere the brain takes time to process from switching from costing to FM to IT to economics, and then it's like, you know, okay, exactly what's happening, I don't know. So there's a lot of small components. Becker has done a good job, I think, of getting everything together and giving you the main important things. The skills practice videos by Mike Patanza are really, really good. You need to go through all the skill videos for reg, or for all of them, for all the subjects, I think. They're really good. They give you a lot of insight as to what AICPA requires you to do and what are we doing, basically. Written communications are important. The structure of the introduction, the main point, and getting the technical aspect of that point, and then the conclusion. You need to follow that structure to get those marks.